Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today we're going to be taking a look at ESF builds and what I've learned so far from flying the site. Now, ESF stands for Empire Specific Fighter. That means it's the Scythe, the Reaver, and the Mosquito. They all fly close enough to each other in performance and stuff like that that you can really transfer builds across factions and have them work pretty much on the same level. There will be minor differences and stuff like that here and there, but for the most part the tactics and flying style should all be the same. Now, the first thing I did when upgrading my ESF was getting the air-to-ground rockets, and these are called different things for each faction. Vanu, they're called photon pods, and they're kind of on the pricier side. They will end up costing you about 1,000 cert points. Otherwise, you can drop a little bit of station cash and get them right off the bat. But these are key for taking out ground targets. Now, the default gun for all faction fighters is actually pretty good at taking out ground targets. But when compared to the rocket pods, they really just pale in comparison. And you can actually do a mixture of rocket pods and regular gun. You can fire an entire barrage of rockets at, say, a tank. If that doesn't kill it, switch over to your regular gun and finish it off. So the default gun on the fighters is actually quite good for air-to-ground targets. It's okay for air-to-air, but if you're going to be building a air-to-air fighter, you might want to think about upgrading. Now, the great thing about ESFs is that you have a great variety of how you want to fly them and how you want to customize them. You can create an interceptor and just go after other air targets. You can create a ground pounder and just go after ground targets exclusively, or you can create a hybrid that can deal with ground and deal with air, but not exactly be a master of either. Now, let me tell you guys about how I started upgrading my fighter and how I've been upgrading it and where I want to take it ultimately. Now, in the beginning, I had the default gun. I got rocket pods, which made me extremely effective against ground targets. Not a lot of people had a lot of cert points in the beginning of the game, so there weren't super upgraded fighters, so I didn't have to worry too much about interceptors taking me out as well. I was able to handle myself against other fighters, take them on pretty well, and it was, for the most part, even matches against other fighters out there. Later, I upgraded to the turbo laser for the Vanu, and each faction has their own rapid-fire anti-air main cannon. That's what I'm using right here. It has a very small clip, but it does maximum amount of damage in a short period of time, and it's great for taking out air targets, as you can see right there. Ultimately, though, the anti-air main weapons are very expensive, and they're going to cost you even more cert points if you want to make them effective. Default, when you first purchase them or unlock them, they're not going to be very effective. You're going to have to spend several hundred cert points just to make them decent. The clip size is so small that if you miss any of your firing when you're chasing an enemy fighter, you will end up spending a lot of ammo and only be able to take down one or two fighters before having to go get more ammo. I've run out of ammo with this thing so many times in aerial battles and had to retreat because of it. But now that I have it at sort of a medium level of upgrades, I'm really enjoying it. It's allowing me to basically ward off interceptors that come to try and take me out. I don't necessarily go looking for air combat, but if it's there, I can definitely handle it with my sort of hybrid setup now. I'm using the anti-air primary and the photon pods as a secondary to deal with lots of ground targets. The anti-air primary can actually take out ground targets, it's just not quite as effective. Now, to complement my hybrid airframe setup, I've got the hover stability airframe performance upgrade. I've gotten that to the second level. They're kind of pricey. The first level is 100 certs, second level is 200, and the third and final level is 400 cert points. You have the option of going for the dogfighting airframe, the hover stability airframe, or the racer high speed airframe. The reason why I went with hover stability was not necessarily to be better at hovering, but actually because it improves your vertical thrust and your air braking. Two things which I find extremely useful when going for ground targets and actually just being able to maneuver quickly even in dogfights. That vertical thrust improvement really does help, and the fast braking will sometimes get somebody on your tail to fly right past you, and it'll also allow you to make extremely quick landings at repair pads if you need to. Just make that really fast landing, get in, repair, and get out again. There's currently a lot of debate over which airframe seems to be the most effective or what they actually all do. Like the top speed one, people aren't sure if you actually fly faster with that one or if you can actually combine your hover stability, vertical thrust, and forward thrust together to achieve a speed that's almost on the same level with that one. There's a lot of debate on like the forums and in Reddit, so it'll be interesting to see what people kind of conclude from those tests. But I can tell you that hover stability is a nice one. I'm not regretting getting that upgrade. I might play around with some later on, but currently I think I'm gonna take it to the max level because I am enjoying it. Now you might have seen my screen turn green there for a second. That's because I've upgraded my photon pods with night vision. This is helping me spot a lot of ground targets in my air-to-ground photon rockets. This is extremely helpful for picking off infantry targets. The main reason why is because when you fire your photon pods, there's a giant explosion after impact. That explosion can often obscure your vision of infantry targets. However, with night vision equipped, that explosion dissipates much faster and you're able to keep your aimer on target and able to snipe infantry targets from longer ranges and just spot them out much easier as well. So it's great for air-to-ground setups. I recommend getting night vision as soon as you possibly can. And I was running without it for far too long, and as soon as I equipped it, I realized just how powerful it can be. Now, in utility slots for upgrading your ESF, I recommend going with flares. Now, you could try playing around with other systems, but there's so many ground-to-air lock-on rockets these days, or interceptor configured ESFs with lock-on rockets, that you're just gonna need those flares to stay alive. They usually give you enough time to get out of an intense combat situation without taking any damage, or at least only getting hit by one missile. They do have a long cooldown time and they're very expensive to upgrade, but in my opinion, they're absolutely necessary for staying alive. Now in the defensive slot, early on you could get the Nanite auto repair system. The first level isn't too expensive and you should be able to run with it for quite some time. But ultimately, once you start building up your cert points, I would recommend going for the composite armor, as you will be able to absorb a lot more small arms fire and flak fire from the ground. Which honestly, if you're running a hybrid system or just any sort of fighter system, you're gonna run into a lot of flak cannons and you wanna be able to reduce that damage you take from them as much as possible. I'm sure a lot of balancing and improvements are gonna come into the upgrades for all the ESFs. Certain systems right now just don't seem useful at all, so I'm sure they're going to tweak the numbers and percentages here and there, and then other systems might become more useful. But for the time being, I think a hybrid fighter is a great way to go if you're unsure of what you want to do. And from there, you can decide what kind of flying style really suits you the best. You might end up preferring dogfights, so you could equip air-to-air missiles for a secondary gun, use your air-to-air gun for your primary, and then use a dogfighting airframe or maybe even a racer high-speed airframe if you want to catch up to your foes that are running away. And one last quick tip, which I've mentioned before, but it really is such a key for being successful in aerial dogfights: you want to bind your pitch up and pitch down keys to something on either your mouse or the keyboard. You can still control your pitch up and pitch down by moving your mouse for sort of adjusting your aim for ground targets, but for getting that maximum turnability in dogfights, you really want to be able to bind it to a key that you can just press and hold to get extreme turning speeds in dogfighting areas. I have them bound to my mouse, my two thumb buttons on my mouse. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.